sixth day of the novena. Today, bring to me the meek and humble souls and the souls of little children, and immerse them in my mercy. These souls most closely resemble my heart. They strengthen me during my bitter agony. I saw them as earthly angels who will keep vigil at my altars. I pour out upon them whole torrents of grace. Only the humble soul is capable of receiving my grace. I favor humble souls with my confidence. Most merciful Jesus,
you yourself accept. Learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. Receive into the Lord of your most compassionate heart all meek and humble souls, and the souls of little children. These souls know all the benefits of your ecstasy, and they are
please be seated. Today's intentions is for the humble souls and the souls of little children. Actually, these two thoughts converge. They come together. You know, in the diary of St. Faustina, spiritual child, or anything mentioned about child in it, is mentioned many, many times. Childhood itself is mentioned 7 times. Childlike, 6 times. Childlikeness, once. Children, 30 times. Humiliated, 5 times. Humiliates, 2 times. Humiliated, 1 time. Humiliation, 13 times. Humiliations, 9 times. Humility, 82 times. This is how important to be humble really means. And it's really very touching to our Lord. I'd like to share with you a story that some years ago, I was in a pre-seminary program and I was listening to a lecture by this priest, Father Jim Flanagan, talk about humility. He came from a very prestigious family, a family of lawyers, one who was the local district attorney, and he started a new religious order. So after his talk, we came outside and we saw this man on the street, and it was raining like it is today. He had no shoes on, no coat on, and he was shivering from the cold. He said to us, "Guys, I'll meet you back in the residence. I'm going to take my brother here for a cup of coffee." The man asked him for a dime for a cup of coffee. He knew what he wanted. So he brought him into this restaurant, made sure he had a good meal, spoke nothing more than about his health, how he should take care of himself, wash himself, because he had body odor that you wouldn't believe. So as he left, he took his shoes off, took his coat off, gave it to the man, and asked him to pray for him, gave him a few dollars in the pocket and said, "Get yourself a good cup of coffee." The man stood there stunned. He didn't know what hit him. That was humility. There are two great saints in our Catholic Church. One is St. Francis of Assisi. He came from nobility as well. And in those times, it was wonderful to be a knight and to have this honor in this profession. Also, Years later, there was another man of similar situation. That was St. Ignatius of Loyola, who came from nobility. And he too wanted to be a great knight, a great warrior. But both learned that that is not the way to go. That true greatness, as Sister Faustina says in her diary, is in loving God and humility. So they stripped themselves of all the nobility, became a beggar on the street. They became a soldier for Christ. What are the hallmarks of humility? Is having others in a higher importance than ourselves. The mark of being meek is to be quiet, gentle, easily imposed. We live in a world that is a desert world. Years ago, there was St. Anthony of the Desert, and he thought he knew it all. He gave his whole life out, went out to the desert to give himself to God. And he said, what more do I need to learn? The Lord says, go in town and stay with Mr. and Mrs. So-so. So he did, and when he came back to his cave in the desert, he said, I don't get it. He said, they were very simple. And that's what our Lord called them to be. Simple. He said, simplicity. That is the hallmark of loving God. And that's what childlikeness is. Not childish, but childlikeness. And what it is to be a child, the statue of the infant child here, is to be trusting, loving, to give yourself over to the authority of others. And in a very simple way, to love. As I mentioned, we live in the desert world here, the desert of noise, the desert of lack of spirituality throughout the world. The evil one is trying to destroy us. He's trying to pull us away from listening to the voice of God in silence. And so our lives have become cluttered with all kinds of things. You know, and as older people begin to face reality, they see that they have accumulated all these different material things, all this wealth, all these material things. And they have too much. They want to be simple, they want to downsize. And that's the reality of our spiritual life, that we need to downsize of all the clutter that's around us, all the noise and everything else, and be silent and give our heart totally to God as a child. And God will bless us in the most profound way. In diary number 335, Sister Faustina saw our Lord as the child Jesus, this humble little child. And she knew whose presence he was in, she was in. And he looked at this child, so helpless, so innocent. And he said, but you are my Lord and my God. You built this whole universe, and yet you come to me in such a way. So many, many times, why? And the Lord says, so that you will learn simplicity and humble of heart. So true greatness lies in loving God and humility. And may God bring us to that stage of life that we may trust him with all our heart and not be worried about all the clamor of the noise around us, but focus in on who he is. Last thought, that in the life that we live here with so much noise, there's a lot of fear and confusion throughout life. One of my favorite scripture passages is that story of the storm on the lake, you know, when Jesus, just after creating this tremendous miracle of feeding 5,000 people, he went up to the mountain to pray, as was his custom. And he said to the apostles, see you on the other side of the lake. So they get in the boat, and these are tough fishermen, and the boat was going up and down and everything, they're feeling the wind, and they're frightened, they're going to drown. Suddenly, they see a Lord walking on the water. They don't recognize him. They think it was a ghost. But then Peter says, Lord, if that is you, bid me to come to you. And what did Peter do? He stepped out of the boat and he started walking towards Jesus. But then he gave in to the distraction of the wind and the waves hitting him. He took his focus off Jesus and he went under. But even then, the good Lord in his mercy brought him out, brought him back from the boat, said, be calm. So the point is to always keep our focus on our Lord, on God's mercy, His mercy comes right from this little child who will be yet to be like and resemble.